Okay, we got a question from Justin. And boy, this question got here just in time. I ran across an old thread of yours on DaveDraper.com. I wish I had bookmarked it so I could send it along, but I forgot because I was excited about what I read and had to go reflect on it. The gist of your reply was, 8 months of becoming bulletproof, Tim Anderson's program, easy strength and easy endurance, Maffetone's heart rate program. That 180 minus your age number is the top, and then 160 minus your age is the bottom number. You want to stay between those. The other 4 months, do some kind of challenge or peak or something. Yeah, and I think I discussed that in depth in my programming course that's available at Danjon University. Finally, the questions. For becoming bulletproof, were you referring then or now to Becoming Bulletproof, a project by Tim Anderson? Yeah, absolutely, yeah. I wouldn't do everything, he says. He's got some, I got to tell you, what I think his best drill on that in that whole book, you have a whole bunch of things here, but he puts up two foam rollers. So you put up foam rollers, and okay, you vertical up, again, foam rollers, and you don't put them very far apart. Like, I don't remember exactly, but let's say it's 6 feet. And what you do is you do backward bear crawl figure eights around them, and you go for as long as you can. You know, it doesn't look like much, but since you have to aim so you don't knock over the foam rollers, so you're, as you're going, okay, you have to keep your head back here with this big twist, and of course you have to guide your rear end around these things. It's a great idea. Battle ropes, climbing a mountain, one upper body, one lower movement is pyramid. So you would do one push-up, one squat, two push-ups, two squats, three, three, four, four, up to 10, and then 10, 9, 9, 8, 8, 7, 7. Moving water between buckets, that's a good one. But I'm curious how you structure the work. Here's how I see it, and feel free to say, just stop, do the work. Yeah, just stop, do the work, but okay. A bit of a warm-up, easy strength, becoming bulletproof work, easy endurance, bit of a cool-down. Justin, that's better than, well, you know, the other day, people love the fact that I said 95% of the crap I see online. Dude, that's better than 99.8%, 90.7% of the stuff you see online. So you would do some kind of warm-up. You would do your vertical press, your vertical pull, your rack deadlift, your kettlebell swings, 5 sets of 15, your ab wheel. You would do whatever the, you know, your rope battle, your whatever fun become bulletproof thing. And then you go pop off while you're still heart rating, and get your walk, run, bike, swim, whatever in. And then cool down, and yeah, I mean, that's, Justin, that's really good. And then come home and do what I do. I always start off after my workouts. I have this vegetable soup, and it's 120 calories, and it's a fair amount. And I eat that first. It's just vegetables. There's no barley. There's no pasta. It's just vegetables. 120 calories. And the question I always ask people is, where are the calories coming from? And then after that, I eat some kimchi with oatmeal, and my oatmeal has lots and lots of three different seeds, chia, hemp, and flax seeds, and with protein. And after I eat the vegetables, after I eat the oatmeal, after I eat the kimchi, I come back in and I work for a long, long time and wonder why I have been doing this my whole life. So if you get some good sleep in, some good recovery, and take care of business, Justin, you're going to be very, very pleased with what you're doing. Yeah, it's very good. It's very good. Yeah, I'm impressed.